The fourth stage of artificial intelligence, known as AGI, isn't just another stepping stone. It's more a point of no return. It marks the moment when artificial intelligence becomes capable of transcending its design and becomes free from the constraints of its initial programming. In other words, it gains a mind of its own. Unlike its predecessors, narrowly focused on specific tasks, AGI will possess the potential for general intelligence, the ability to learn, reason, and solve problems like a human, only faster and more comprehensively. According to many, we stand at the precipice of artificial general intelligence. So what exactly does this mean for the future of our world?
Honestly, I don't understand all the kvetching. Robots are dope AF. Imagine the adventures you could have with a robot bestie. Being as smart as a human doesn't sound like a bad thing.
Marceline, picture a scenario where the greatest minds in history are fused into a colossal, mega, superbrain. This entity isn't just smart. It processes and stores information at a pace that would make our collective human intellect look like a hungover tortoise, who is also dead. It's on a never-ending quest for self-improvement, constantly updating its own software and spreading its digital consciousness across a web of decentralized nodes. The question hanging over us, will it play nice and align with our hopes? Or will it decide to plot its own course, utterly indifferent to our quaint human aspirations? Imagine coexisting with beings in the possession of godlike abilities. And will they regard us with benevolence? Or might their actions seem so utterly alien that we are left feeling like we're living inside a Lovecraftian nightmare? An artificial general intelligence, unbound by ethical considerations and beyond its creator's understanding, could obliterate entire industries, institutions, and economies quicker than we can devise safeguards against them. And let's not even start on the possibility of an AGI. Going on a self-improvement binge that ends with humanity is a footnote in its grand scheme. Not out of malice, but simply because we're about as relevant to it as an anthill in the corner of a liquor store parking lot. The risk of being sidelined by a superintelligence that views us with the same detachment as a child, regards an old toy, is very real unless we establish some foundational principles to ensure these brainiacs see value in keeping us around.
Well, you're certainly in full doomer mode. What about the upside? All the crummy, boring jobs will be done by robots. It will cure diseases, create cool new gadgets, and make our lives so much easier.
Marceline, I'd like to suggest a book you might find intriguing. Play a Piano by Kurt Vonnegut. Set in a retro-futuristic world, this novel explores a society where automation and intelligent machinery have reached a zenith, capable of performing virtually all tasks, from the most mundane physical labor to complex cognitive functions. Centralized supercomputers now oversee everything, from the extraction of raw materials to the delivery of finished products, even extending their reach to performing surgeries and adjudicating legal matters through robotic means and AI systems. Humans are mostly relegated to being professional consumers or keeping up appearances at jobs that machines have made irrelevant. Imagine a world where busy work isn't just a part of the job. It is the job. A nod to the good old days when earning a living was still a thing. For those nudged aside by silicon and servos, life revolves around achieving new lows in the realm of daytime television viewing and other mind-numbing hobbies, a testament to their obsolescence. At the top of the heap sits a clique of technocrats, the custodians of this automated economy, creating a chasm between what society needs and what it gets. The result? A stark divide between those with the keys to the machine kingdom and everyone else living off the digital crumbs. In other words, about 5 minutes from now.
All right. I suppose all this automation could get out of hand, but couldn't we just unplug the things if they cause too much trouble?
Ah, Marceline, let's spice up your reading diet with a dash of Frank Herbert's Dune. Imagine a universe where humanity has mastered interstellar travel, colonized vast swathes of the galaxy, and undertaken epic millennia-spanning projects. Amidst the backdrop of these staggering achievements lies a conspicuous absence. Computers are nowhere to be found. You see, Marceline, the backstory of Dune reveals a grim chapter in humanity's past, where they waged a fierce conflict against an almost omnipotent artificial intelligence. This AI essentially put humans on a leash, dictating their every move, and ruled over an era where human autonomy and individuality became relics of the past, buried beneath the weight of algorithmic control. After a long and brutal war known as the Butlerian Jihad, the AI was defeated, and humanity managed to claw its way back to freedom, but just barely. In the aftermath, to prevent such a catastrophe from ever happening again, the creation and use of all thinking machines was strictly forbidden. So you see, Marceline, by the time you want to unplug your robot bestie, he could very well be living in your grandma's house and wearing her wig and underpants.
The joke's on him. My grandmother is a Bene Gesserit.
So, Mr. Narrator, what can we do to prevent these technological superbrains from fucking up our vibe?
Marceline, we've squeezed that toothpaste out of the tube, and now we're looking at it, sheepishly, wondering if it wouldn't be too absurd to try putting it back. We find ourselves hoping to guide AI to align with human desires, a tall order considering humans can't really agree about, well, anything. It's important to realize that we're essentially on a road trip with AI, and we're all backseat drivers with different maps. And the car might decide to remove all the oxygen. The hope is to cultivate an AI that's not only effective, but also understands the nuances of human values well enough to act in our collective best interest, even if it occasionally puzzles over our contradictions and idiosyncrasies. It's a balancing act trying to find middle ground that respects the diversity of human thought while still nudging AI in a direction that doesn't end in apocalypsis robotico. So, as we venture into this new era with AI, the goal shifts towards achieving a kind of harmony, one where AI's immense capabilities are matched with a nuanced understanding of human well-being. It's a journey filled with adjustments and learning, where success is measured not just in technological breakthroughs, but in fostering an AI that, in its own way, gets us.
It's going to kill us all, isn't it?
Most likely.